5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. All engine running. Liftoff. We have a liftoff.
Broadcasting worldwide from Paindemonium Studios in Cornwall, this is the Wal of Paine show on Phluid FM.
Hello, good evening, and welcome to Wall of Paine with myself, Leo Bass Driver Paine, and Neil Walters, and that's the wrong lower third right there, buddy, I tell you.
Hey, Steve Prout's growing his hair.
Yeah, indeed.
Whoopsie. I was going to say the Paine is back in the Wall of Paine.
Indeed.
And Prout is out.
Prout is indeed out. At the moment, he's been standing in for me for the last few weeks, so massive thanks to him for that.
Sterling work.
Yeah, it needed to be done. And yeah, how are you doing? It's been a while, hasn't it?
Yeah, it's always been all right. We've gone there completely.
Yeah, no, that's all right. We're still there.
Oh, are we?
Yeah.
Hello to Claire and Ian in the chat room. Speaking of Claire earlier.
Yeah.
Got some bits and pieces to tell you about, Claire.
Oh.
Hello to Samantha. Don't know Samantha. Hello to Sandy. Where's old Prout's out tonight, isn't he?
Yeah, well, he is out, I think. Is he out?
Where's he gone? He's gone somewhere specific, hasn't he? To do something specific.
Is it something to do with his brother-in-law or
something? It is something to do with his brother-in-law, yeah. What did you think of that opening track, The Drunken Sailor, Leo's new tune?
Like that, yeah, it's good, I haven't actually listened to any Leo for a little while, actually. So, it's good to catch up again.
I just thought that. I thought that's quite Cornish. That's a good show opener. What should we do with A Drunken Sailor?
Yeah.
Put him in the rowboat till he's sober.
Yep.
Or put him in the back with the captain.
Yeah. There you go.
With the captain's daughter. Here we are, we're back. Oh, Neil, what's
Leo Paine? What I was looking over there for. There you go.
Hey. That's pretty good.
Indeed.
That's pretty good. You've been working on a video, haven't you, Dave?
I have.
You've been doing lots of stuff. We've been a bit all over the place and between studios and implosion of studios, and you've been streamlining studios.
Mm.
Sorting me out with OBS.
Yep.
Sorting other people out with
Jack
OBS.
Jack Ryder, yep, for example.
Doing videos.
Yep.
Which we've got coming up later. Great video from Combustion.
Indeed, yes we do. I've been working super hard. I just want to send some shout outs to folks in the chat room, Claire and Ian, Sandy, Samantha. Massive shouts to you all. Yay, Leo is back, Sandy says. Thank you very much. Good to be back indeed.
Yeah. Am I moving that camera the wrong way?
You are. Let me just sort that out for
I want to go in the middle.
You want to go
I be in the middle. That's where way. I want to be. I want to be in the middle.
And I want to go a little bit this way.
Yeah, you go a little bit that way. I'm gonna sort out some tunage. I'll tell you what. Vengeant, your mate Vengeant.
Yes, Vengeant indeed.
He's got a new tune out.
He does indeed, yeah. He's had a few new tunes out the last couple of weeks actually. I think he had the Prodoggy. Have you seen that one?
Smacked
my bitch up by the Prodoggy.
Brilliant.
A sample of his dog.
That's good. Yeah. And Claire, I was talking to Claire earlier on the phone. She phoned me up. She's just been to see Iron Maiden. But got in the VIP box.
Oh, nice. That's
absolutely
a good touch.
And she's put me onto this band called Electric Callboy.
Okay.
Got a song called Hyper Hyper, which we're going to play later. It'll give you, literally, I listened to it earlier, it will give you an aural reaming.
Oh, Electric Callboy, have they had that on BBC yet?
I think Hugh Edwards is in it. Oh, sorry, have we got a restraining order or whatever it's called? What's that? What do they call it?
His wife did come out last night and announced.
Oh, did she? What, she's gay?
No.
Oh, right. Okay.
There's obviously the ongoing investigations into that, but allegedly, allegedly everything. But yes, allegedly, there's been some going on there.
Oh, allegedly.
Allegedly, Steve Prout did cover a little bit of last night.
Yeah.
As the news broke.
It just makes me wonder. We don't want to dwell on Hugh Edwards. We're going to play some tunes in a minute because it's far more interesting than some Welsh anchorman who's
out there in TV land watching. Tell us if we get cut off.
If he's got some issues, which he allegedly has claimed depression and some mental issues and so on and so forth, didn't address these before he got caught, though, did he?
He has talked about it a lot in the past, has been interviewed over specific issues involving himself and his family. So, at this moment, one can only again assume innocence. Everything's alleged. We have no charges or anything like that at this time. So, you know, we'll see.
Right,
you know,
gonna give it that. I'm giving it that. That was a bit of a manic entrance.
Yeah.
For those two tunes. We've got, good friend of the show, Robyn Dilnot.
Mm-hmm.
Hello, Robyn.
Yes.
She's not in the
Robyn.
Chat room, and mellowed out the Dilnots. The Dilnots are all over. Robyn posted a little thing up on YouTube the other day, and it was a lovely little short film, and the music really caught my ear. I was going to say caught my eye then. But fortunately, she posted who it was.
Excellent.
And it's a girl called Kiki Rockwell, who we've subsequently started following.
Excellent.
And then also yesterday, there's a YouTube video gone up from This Is Cornwall Short Films, in which Robyn is starring, which I just showed you and I watched last night.
And it looks absolutely fantastic.
It is absolutely stunning. So get on, it's on YouTube. Yeah. We'll look it up again in a minute and we'll give a shout out. So I thought, just to calm things down, we'll play that Kiki Rockwell tune and we'll play a bit of Robyn Dilnot's cover of Half the World Away, which she released a while ago.
Yep.
Whilst we chill out and look up the video, and we'll tell you in a minute when we get back how to find it.
Yeah, absolutely. Fantastic. Here we go.
My lover left me for dead. Got under my skin and said it's all in my head. My lover left me for dead. My pretty little body keeps the wolves fed. But I can't force his end. No, I can't make him stay. Got too much love to give to let it sit here and decay. Now light is just beyond my reach. The ship is sunk, but still the sailors wash up on the beach. My lover left me out in the cold. He's busy chasing silver, got no room for gold. My lover left me out in the cold. Headed straight to her place, or so I've been told. No, I can't make him stay. Got too much love to give to let it sit here and decay. Now light is just beyond my reach. The ship is sunk, but still the sailors wash up on the beach.
Busy writing a great novel or busting out hitting the sixth face and yeah, can you just put it down there please? No, not a step away and just I'll sort it. God, you cannot get the stuff. Anyway, when I'm not busy being amazing, I like to listen to Fresh Radio? Phluid FM. Keep up the good work, boys.
Still scratching around in the same old.
Beautiful, lovely little tune.
Yeah, great track line, isn't it?
Yeah, fantastic. Yeah, it's Robyn Dilnot there. The film that they've just released, incidentally, Leo, that I just showed you when I came in, is called Wonders of the Lost. There it is, look, and it's available on YouTube. Mm. And when I came in just earlier, I said, oh, it's already had 173 views in less than a day. Mm-hmm. And since opening it up again just to show the camera now, it's already had 184. So it's just had already another 11 views since I got
it. Isn't it? Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, we have watched it 10 times since you got here. So.
We haven't. No. But it's great, isn't it? And the cinematography and everything on it is absolutely
fantastic.
Really, really,
really
good.
Really nice, yeah.
So well done, Robyn and the guys, for that. Filmed by... This is Cornwall Films, who apparently are also available. You can look them up on their website. They do a lot of wedding photography. There's a lot of drone work in there, which is fantastic. So that's another great local company. There's a lot going on here.
There's an awful lot going on. We're always trying to promote that ourselves, really, aren't we?
Yeah, and we've got Combustion video, as we've said, coming up. Now, the last video you did, Leo, for the Undercover Dungarees, which was part of the Rock Project, is had almost 400 views on YouTube.
Yeah, that's indeed.
So Combustion have got their work cut out for them when we play this, haven't they?
It's quite a good number already.
Yeah, and me and Prouty, of course, went down and saw Cameron and some of the other guys down at the Rock Project in Plymouth again this week.
Yes, we did. Yeah.
So they're all keeping up the good work. But like I say, Claire and Ian, went off to see Iron Maiden, got put in the VIP suite, and she said that the gig, because our neighbour Jason went to see this gig as well, she said that absolutely phenomenal. Nicko McBrain is 72, and he is all over that kit, like, whatever. I mean, he is a phenomenal drummer.
Yeah.
And Claire said that, you know, not so much like the old days, sprinting around, but there's still plenty of energy on stage, considering the average age of Iron Maiden is 66.
Wow.
And you've still got Adrian Smith and Dave Murray, Steve Harris. Mm. So you've still got three of the founding members in there.
Yeah, that's
and Nicko McBrain's been there since Peace of Mind, fourth album.
Mm.
And of course, what was it? Bruce joined on the third album, didn't he? And then they had a little bit of a break where they had that other fella in. But I can't remember who he is, but Bruce is back, obviously. Been back for a while.
Yeah. Dickinson.
Absolutely. He's a great singer. And we've got, coming up later also, we've got Tipple of the Week. Got an absolute banging Tipple of the Week from our friend Johnny.
It looks awesome for me. It's looking fantastic.
This
looks right up my street.
Oh, you are going to love this. This is rapidly becoming my favourite drink of the year. It's... we'll talk about it a little bit later, but it's Pipeline Pilsner, and it is a single hopped. It's not brewed again with additional hops. This is just the hopping process in the first fermentation, and it is
spot on.
Beautiful. And look at those cans dripping with condensation and calling to you
they're just
from the other side of the room. It's uber refreshing.
Yeah.
Beautiful taste. I promised you after we played those two little chilled out tunes, and I said to Claire earlier, I promise I'll play this new band she's discovered.
Mm.
Right? So, Electric Callboy. Mm. Never heard of them?
Well, like I say, we may hear more about Electric Callboys in the coming days, from what I hear, up to four accusations now.
Okay. Yeah, no, this is an electric This is Electric Call Boy.
Well, kind of the same thing, right, isn't it?
Yeah.
You know,
and they're not Welsh. I mean, allegedly. Yeah. If it was somebody who was Welsh that had been called out.
Where are they from? Not sure.
Shall we have a look? You keep talking.
Research.
You keep talking and I'll tell you. I'm surprised Claire hasn't come in and told us.
Yeah.
Oh, amazing. They were, mate. That's Iron Maiden she's talking about.
Yeah.
The support act as well, incidentally, for Iron Maiden were fantastic. And a friend of mine sent me a little clip of them.
Awesome.
Right, you keep talking.
Of course, looking for some gigs, then check out the gig guide. It was in last week's Cornish Times, but conveniently, it is also online, both at the Cornish Times and at fluidrecords.co.uk, where indeed you will find links through to all of our fantastic webbing. We've got artist features on there, we've got our merchandise store on there, and you can link through to Phluid Vision and Phluid FM, where you'll find all of our credits, track listings, and on-demand section with like well over 500 items between video and audio now for you to check out.
Too
I
much.
Think we're up to like 136 videos
Are they all top quality though, aren't they?
They are all top quality, yeah. And we have a few of them tonight. We will probably play you a couple of videos over the course of the evening, including the Combustion one, because we've got a few lined up.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
But first of all, Germany, by the way. They're from Germany,
which
is also ironic because I've got our friend from Germany, Saint Jig X. Do you remember we played him?
Yes,
Bitterger.
Yeah, Bitterger.
He's got his new song out called "Fucked Up."
Oh,
I've been listening to that, so I've got that in the playlist.
Fickle.
So we'll have yeah. Nice. Well, yeah. Ironically, everything is sung in German apart from the title.
Oh God, it's
so I think he's obviously done it for an exported British market.
There was another German band, famous one that I wanted us to play, and I've forgotten the damn name of them now, but they did their own version of One Vision, Einswacken or something like that.
Oh, right, okay.
We got to check that out. That's hilarious. But if you don't want to have to travel so far for a gig, don't forget the Scribes are playing in Newquay tomorrow night.
They are, and we'll read out a little bit of the gig guide to let you know what's happening this weekend in a minute.
Yep,
until then, if you don't want an hour all reaming, go and put the kettle on or do a little bit of crochet for 3 minutes and 33 seconds.
Reaming.
If you do not an oral one, an aural one. If you do want an aural.
If you want an oral reaming, I suggest you pop down to a broadcasting house or a new broadcasting house in central London. I believe Shepherd's Bush. Go check it out.
Bush.
I've been there.
Yeah. Well, you don't want to go there now.
Mate, taking a dump was like throwing a hot dog down a pipe.
I tell you what was funny, when Prouty put up that Guess Who is next, and it was all the BBC. Anyway, so, courtesy of Ian and Claire, this is Electric Callboy, Hyper Hyper. You can get your dog back from under the couch now. Kettle's boiled. Get your tea. Did you like that?
Yeah, that was awesome.
Good,
man.
Isn't it?
It
starts off though like it's going to be a little bit of a dance tune, and then it just goes super dark.
Yeah,
Claire's absolutely right. It's Rammstein, isn't it?
Like I was going to say, Till Lindemann's getting a bit of all reaming at the moment, given that he's been up to no good as well.
Ooh.
Sounds like you should be forming a band. Like, you could have a pretty cool band here if you had Till Lindemann backed by Rolf Harris.
You could have the people who dance at the back. You could have the BBCettes.
Yeah, well, like Ronettes. They've had some of that already, apparently, haven't they? Do you not remember when newscasters did Comic Relief and they did Street Transvestite, didn't they?
Oh, good
and
grief.
Guess who was a
good
member
of that
team
if
at
I
the
say
time?
So myself.
I think we've done our Tim Curry before,
haven't we? We did that on the movie night.
Don't you know the Congo? It's the best film.
Could you imagine Hugh Edwards, for example, just randomly
I'm pretty sure he was Frankenfurter in that version.
Slipknot meets Eurovision.
Yeah. Well, to be fair, that would probably fit in a Eurovision these days, because you had
Germany always come out with a Norway.
Or Finland. Finland, man, with Lordi.
Slipknot meets Eurovision.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yes, yeah. Like it.
Euronaut.
Let's make that band
Slip
happen.
Vision.
Slip Vision. Yeah, Slip or, Vision. Or Euronaut.
Euronaut. Yeah.
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 Because is there tribute band called Slipped Knot or
something like that? Yeah.
Not Slip. It's just the other way around, isn't it? The tribute band Slipknot. Yeah, Not Slip.
I saw another one they weren't so cool. They were called Half Hitch.
Oh, yeah, running bowling.
Yeah.
So, do you want a bit more German music while we're on?
I'll tell you who are good though. Reef. Speaking about nuts.
Oh yeah.
Put your hands on.
We'll have a little bit more German music later on in the show.
That in Russia. Not allowed that team in Russia. Thanks, YouTube. Every time we upload Pat's Night Out, one of his bed tracks will never get played in Russia.
Why can't you play Reef in Russia?
Apparently, they don't like putting your hands on my hole.
Really?
Same can't be said for BBC presenters, it seems, but, you know.
Isn't
allegedly.
It whole as in whole, though, like the whole of me?
Put your hand on my hole. It could also be the hole in my personality. Run your fingers through my soul.
Oh, I thought it was
run
a hole.
Run your fingers through my soul.
But I thought it was... And actually, we should play that and watch the lyrics go, because I thought it was whole as in your whole person.
Yeah, we should
put your hands on my hole, all of me, and run your fingers through my soul.
Yeah.
Maybe I'm wrong.
Yeah, I mean, at least he doesn't.
Maybe Hugh Edwards does it allegedly. Yeah. Just plucked out randomly out in there, puts his hand on your soul and runs his fingers up your hole. I mean, I'm not quite sure.
At least the lead singer of Reef doesn't suffer from the James Hetfield thing. He only ends a couple of words with ah.
Yeah,
I was explaining this to the good lady driver earlier. We're watching the video to Enter Sandman. You watched that video. Good God, seriously, epilepsy warning for that one. And remember, this was before sort of mainstream use of computers, so it's probably hand edited, frame by frame, ridiculous. Just noting how, again, you listen to James Hetfield, everything ends like this, even words that don't end in an ah. It's basically a southern state preacher.
So if he says it literally sounds like he's chuckling to himself. He just goes,
yeah. Well, there are several tunes where he does, in fact, go, ooh, ah, yeah.
Anyway, we digress about James Hetfield.
Yeah.
This isn't the James Hetfield. Christ, we've got a full.
Yeah, yeah.
Who's
it's filling right up.
What was that?
Bonzo Deathbug.
Bonzo Deathbug? Who's by Bonzo Deathbug?
Hello, Bonzo.
I hope Bonzo Deathbug's a fan of Ashley Harding.
Yeah. Well, who wouldn't be? Because Ashley Harding is fantastic.
We're going to play a bit of Ashley Harding now. Well, not only play it, you're going to see him.
Yeah, because this is going to be from our exclusive recordings of All Vision Live down at JJ's Bar Liskard a couple of months ago. Ooh,
Bonzo Deathbug.
Yeah. Oh, and hello, Angela. Angela's
in.
Hello,
Angela. That'd be my sister-in-law.
Mm.
Angela will like this, because this...
In-law, is that like...
I was showing Angela the other day, because she's our sound engineer, obviously, for the Morzim, and she's working, doing fantastic from when we did a gig lifted all of the sound, and she's putting it through. You'll know more about this. Angela's probably going, Neil, shut up. You don't know what you're talking about. And Angela, you're quite right. I don't. But she's putting it all through the processing thing on the computer that makes it sound better, and it's absolutely brilliant.
Yeah.
So she's putting together like an album.
So you sound good now.
Oh yeah.
So well, I'm actually, funny you mention that, I've got a recording of yours in this playlist as well, a live recording of yours.
Well, I played Angela the record, because she'd never seen it before. She's never seen her own band before, recorded from JJ's. And she was there, because she said, oh yes, I remember Leo trying to plug stuff in left, right and centre. And she said, I didn't think it was going to work. So this is another recording that you did down at JJ's of Ashley Harding. So we'll have a bit of...
This is going to be Ashley Harding with possibly...
we can't fit any more people in the chat room, which is great.
Oh, no, we can. It's just, the listing won't go that far.
James Hetfield's in.
So we're gonna have a nice bit of Sweet Child of Mine by Ashley Harding, live from JJ's.
Reminds me of a childhood memory where everything was fresh as a bright blue sky. Now and then when I see her face, she takes me away to that special place. And if I stay too long, I'd probably break down and cry. Sweet child of mine, oh, sweet love of Now, where do we go? child, sweet child of mine. Thank you very much. Cheers.
Yo, yo, yo.
Phluid Records Phluid in the place Records. To be. Nice we to are here be. At Glastonbury and Glastonbury celebrating Festival. Nothing less than the best. Phluid Records.
Keep Check it out.
Every time.
Listen to Phluid Records. Let's go. Boy.
Yeah. Isn't Ashley Harding, Leo, not only a phenomenal guitarist, a brilliant singer, a living human jukebox, he's such a lovely guy.
Yeah, he is fantastic.
Such a lovely, smiley, happy guy, hardest working musician ever. He plays in three bands.
Yeah.
And followed there by the Scribes, Johnny and Sean. Shout outs to Johnny and Sean, who took the trouble to send us that little clip live from Glasgow.
Yes, indeed.
A couple of weeks ago. That's our most watched reel.
Oh, hello, here we go. Angela in the chat room there saying, shut up, Studio One, they sound shit, I'm making them good.
Well, that's outrageously rude.
Well, I can attest to that, I've watched them at work.
Yeah, it's the drummer, it's the drummer.
Hard work from what I see.
Well, you've worked with us, drummer's bloody awful. Mind you, the singer's not much better, it's only the bass player that keeps us together.
Oh, classic.
And Charlie that comes up with all the ideas.
Yeah.
I couldn't even make band rehearsal this week, so I've been busy every night.
Yeah. Well, shouts to Bonzo Defberger there, saying brilliant cover. It is indeed a fantastic cover.
Isn't it fantastic?
And he has, like Neil says, he's a walking jukebox, name a tune, he'll play it, which we did with several tunes throughout the evening. And he's always expanding his repertoire. And as you have heard there, it sounds like there's more than one guitar. It's a loop pedal, it's not a backing track. So he's playing that all into a loop pedal, a complex one, with multiple layers, and doing it all himself on the spot, which is fantastic. And if you want to see more of that, because there's a whole, what, like 2 hour performance of that.
Oh, all night.
Yeah, so we've got the whole show up on vision.fluidrecords.co.uk. And if you want to listen to the audio only at fm.fluidrecords.co.uk, go over there and check it out. It's in the Vision Live section in our video archives, and I believe it's still in our featured videos section on the front page.
It is. Yeah. We have hot news, hot off the press. It's not about Hugh Edwards.
You've got hot news, have you? I've got some hot news.
Again, just a name I've randomly plucked out of the ether. The quiz is a go.
Oh, sweet, fantastic.
Did you say you've got a dongle?
I do.
Or was that Hugh Edwards again? Yeah. Allegedly. Just a name I plucked out of the air.
I thought you had yours. Have you not got yours?
Oh, I have. Yeah, I've got it in the rucksack.
Fantastic.
I'll tell you what we'll do.
Out in a bit. That's okay. No worries.
Let's have another bit of German music, because I did promise everybody a bit more German music.
Und das
Das Bitter. We'll have that.
Want to play Big Voice, yeah.
And then whilst we're playing St. Jigex, our friend from over the channel, when I at him in the playlist, I always do everything in German as well, and he really appreciates the fact that I write up in German specifically for him, and he always comes back and writes in English to us, which is lovely. So let's play.
Mein Gott, mein Scheißkleberes Groschen.
No, that's what he said last time, and I said, stop talking about Hugh Edwards, it's literally just a name we've plucked out of the air.
Fantastic.
So this is St. Jigex, and as I say, it's all in German, which his last one was, apart from the title, which is called Fucked Up.
Okay.
Which you'll guess as you go. And I'm going to go and search for a dangly thing to stick in the slot of my phone.
Fantastic.
Said Hugh Edwards to his wife.
Hey Jean, got the sauce, boy. Tut mir leid, dass es mit uns beiden nicht geklappt hat. Du rufst an, doch ich kann nicht ran, du liegst wieder nachts wach. Du bist unterwegs, weiß nicht, wo's dir geht, und ich bin schon wieder fucked up. Deine Freundin meint, ich tue dir nicht so gut, und deswegen bin ich fucked up, fucked up, fucked up. Ja, zu viel Weiß, zu viel Lines, gibt das Lean in das Sprite. Ich geh wieder viel zu weit, heute Nacht komm ich nicht heim. Du fühlst dich wieder so allein, aber keiner hört dich schreien. Keiner will wissen, wie es dir geht, doch du hast bis heute überlebt. Du fühlst dich wieder so allein, aber keiner hört dich schreien. Keiner will wissen, wie es dir geht, doch du hast bis heute überlebt. Ja, du fühlst dich wieder so allein, aber keiner hört dich schreien. Keiner will wissen, wie es dir geht, doch du hast bis heute überlebt. Du hast bis heute überlebt, überlebt.
Hey,
tut mir leid, dass es mit uns beiden nicht geklappt hat. Du rufst Schaden, doch ich kann nicht ran, du lügst wieder nachts wach. Du bist unterwegs, weiß nicht, wo's dir geht und ich bin schon wieder fucked up. Deine Freundin meint, ich tu dir nicht so gut und deswegen bin ich fucked up, fucked up, fucked up. Ja, aha. Wir singen und blühen, aber mir geht's gut. Vielleicht geh ich heute drauf, aber ich nehm das in Kauf. Ja, keiner will wissen, wie's dir geht. Doch du hast bis heute überlebt. Keiner will wissen, was dir geht. Doch du hast bis heute überlebt. Tut mir leid, dass es mit uns beiden nicht geklappt hat. Du rufst an, doch ich geh nicht ran, du lügst wieder nachts wach. Du bist unterwegs, weiß nicht, wie's dir geht und ich bin schon wieder fucked up. Deine Freundin meint, ich tu dir nicht so gut und deswegen bin ich fucked up, fucked up, fucked up. Ja.
Sauce,
tut mir leid, dass es mit uns beiden nicht geklappt hat. Du rufst an, doch ich geh nicht ran, du lügst wieder nachts wach. Du bist unterwegs, weiß nicht, wie's dir geht und ich bin schon wieder fucked up. Deine Freundin meint, ich tu dir nicht so gut und deswegen bin ich fucked up, fucked up, fucked up. Ja.
So yeah, he turns around to Archer and he says, "No, Cyril, when they're dead, they're just hookers." We're back.
Couldn't get away with playing that on Radio 1, could you?
Well, I don't know. These days, yeah, probably. It used to be like the sort of reserve for Radio 1 Extra.
I'm going to put the phone up.
You're going to put the phone on it?
This thing never bloody works, does it? I always end up holding a phone. But let's give it a go.
Well, yeah, like give it a whirl because it did work when I phoned you.
I'm on audio.
Right.
So we put the phone up. It's ringing in my headphones. Why does it only bloody work when you do it? Oh no, it's gone. It's still calling, but it's gone. It never works.
It did work before.
I don't like this feature. Speaker?
Headphones?
Yep.
Has she answered? Is he saying anything to us?
No, can't hear anything. It's not on mute. Let's just unplug.
It did work for a second there.
I don't think that's working. What do you think?
I'm intrigued.
Speaker?
Working?
Speaker working. Oh, hello! But it's only working on the speaker. It's only working on the speaker, so we're going to have to unclip again.
That's really interesting, isn't it?
Yeah, right. Okay, Andrew, we're going to put you on the speaker. Say something. Can you hear us?
I can hear you.
Right.
How come it worked when I did it then?
I don't know. Right, so we're going to hold you up to the microphone again, as we do normally, because our technology in this studio clearly doesn't extend to Apple, Leo.
Well, no, it worked when
you're
I phoned
so
you.
So anti-Apple.
When I phoned you, it worked fine.
Yeah, but it only works when you phone me.
I agree with Leo. He should be anti-Apple.
Yeah.
Oh. Brilliant. Oh, brilliant cover, says Bonzo Deathburger.
Yeah.
Don't do it again. It's not working. No, that's horrible. We're just going to go for it over the speaker.
Hold up.
Oh, Leo's got... We've got tech support in there. That's not working. It's horrible. Take it out.
Wow.
Get rid of that. That was £12 and that was a complete waste of money. So, Andrea...
There you go. Where did you get that?
Oh, God knows.
Don't go
some
again.
Dodgy shop. B&M, I think.
Yeah.
Right, can you still hear us now? Shit. Hello, Andre, can you hear us?
See, now your phone's going crazy.
Right, let's... Oh, she's hung up.
She's gone.
She had enough.
Bloody stupid. Something always... We have to... If we did a show, right, where... Are you back?
Hello,
yes.
Right.
Yes, she's back. Yeah. Right, okay. Let's get into this quiz while
we've
got
her
online.
We'll try this again off air. I guarantee you it'll work.
Get a clipboard, Leo. Angela, Bonzo Deathburger, Claire and Ian, Sandy, anybody else who's in the chat room, grab your pen, grab your pencil, grab a piece of paper, grab a chalk, grab a blackboard, grab a whiteboard and a whiteboard pen, whatever you've got.
You're going to have to hang on a couple of seconds because you just rang me out of nowhere and I haven't even got the quiz lined up.
Oh. We'll talk amongst ourselves while you go and get the quiz.
Sounds So bear with me, because I was actually sitting quite happily watching you guys, and then the bells have just gone off.
Oh, those bloody bells, eh?
Bloody bells. So I've had to make a mad dash, shut all the windows.
I'm going to have a word with that vicar.
Yeah.
Angela
says she can hear you, and Bonsoda Defberger says, further proof, Apple is just for sad fanboys. Well,
yeah, you wouldn't catch me buying anything Apple.
Of course not.
I do believe, Neil, that
what?
You have an Apple phone.
Oh, I think we're losing you.
because we've got an Apple phone.
And I had to spend Saturday morning taking you step by step how to reinstall your OS after a kernel panic.
Do you know what? Sometimes I just realise I come around to this show to be abused. Now let's get on with this quiz. What's the quiz about?
You haven't come here to be abused.
Wait a minute. I've got to put the lights on now because I can't see because I'm in darkness.
We are nothing, honestly, if not the consummate professionals on this show.
It sounds quite interesting, like people watch us in the dark. Like, is this a thing? If they really want to punish themselves, they turn all the lights out and watch us.
Yeah, no. I was upstairs in the utility, and then the bell started, and I ran downstairs, shut all the windows, and it's very dark in my house.
Right.
But yep. I've had to put the lights on. Anyway, good evening, guys.
Good evening.
Lovely to have you back.
Yeah, thank you very much. It's great to be back, even if I'm kind of fudging it a bit this week.
I've got a lovely quiz lined up for you all. Nice.
And what is the title of this quiz?
Well, I've got two sections to this quiz this week.
Right.
So I'm kind of putting a new spin on it. So I've got quiz of the week and I've got geography.
Ooh.
Five questions in each.
Okay.
So what would you like to choose? Your first one. You can have A or B.
A?
Okay, let's go A.
Yeah.
A is quiz of the week.
Right. Thank God it's not bloody geography because I'm shit on geography.
Yeah, that's why I chose it this week, Neil, because I know you're shit on it.
Yeah. Great. Shit on it. Right.
Shit on it, Neil. Okay, are you ready? Question number one, you chose A, section A, so your first five questions. Are you ready? I hope everyone online has got a pen and paper, and or they can type it in quick enough.
Yeah, type in your answers, guys, on the chat room.
Okay, are you ready?
Yeah.
Question number one. Oh, hang on, I've just switched papers. Whoopsie.
Fantastic.
Got that wrong. What did you want again? Quiz of the week?
Yes.
Yeah, sorry. I've written that on the wrong bit of paper.
Good Lord.
That's question number one. Right, okay. These are a few facts which have been going on recently in the news.
Oh, brilliant.
Nothing to do with Hugh Edwards, I might add.
Damn, okay. I would have been sweet then.
Okay, question number one. Ready?
Yep.
The NHS, National Health Service, celebrated its birthday this week, or I think it was last week. Can you remember how old it is? Is it A, 75 years, B, 10 years, C, 115 years, or D, 80 years?
D. For me. Yeah. Okay.
All right. Oh, Angela wanted geography.
Oh. Yeah, got that.
Okie dokie. Right, moving on to question two. A lion was given VIP health treatment at a London zoo recently. Can you remember what it was for? Was it A, a haircut, B, a broken tooth, C, a sprained ankle, or D, earache? And it was on the news.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, got that.
If it was on the news, I'd have to know that.
Oh, well, you're just looking so baffled by the whole thing.
I know. You need to get, if it's going to be in the news, it needs to have been in the news 20 years ago for me to listen to it.
Yeah.
But carry on, I think I might have that one.
Right. Question number three. As part of the ceremony when King Charles was presented with Scotland's crown jewels, he was also presented with a new what? Was it A, bagpipes,
ooh,
B, a cape, C, a sword, or D, a scepter?
C.
I like Bonzo Deathburger's answer for that one in the chat rooms.
Yeah, that's a good one. I don't think that was one of the options.
Leo, are you actually writing anything down?
Yeah, I'm not. I'm telling Leo my answers and he's writing them down.
Right. Well, don't copy Leo's answers.
I don't think we've got any of the same so far.
Not as far as I'm
concerned. All right. This week, or maybe last week, we learned that an owl... We learned that a group of owl chicks were found in a very strange location. But where were they? Were they A, found in Buckingham Palace, B, Glastonbury Festival,
ooh,
C, Stonehenge, mm, or D, were they found on the Angel of the North?
Oh, it could be any of those.
Owl chicks.
What can just read those answers out again?
Okay, well, so the owl chicks were found in a location. Was it A, Buckingham Palace, B, Glastonbury Festival, C, Stonehenge, or D, Angel of the North?
Perfect, okie dokie. Mm-hmm. And the last question?
And the last question in this round. The iconic tennis tournament Wimbledon is underway. Who was the women's singles champion last year? Right, I have to admit, I apologise, I can't pronounce some of these foreign names. Okay, was it A, Coco Gauff or Gaff? Was it B, Emma Raducanu? Was it C, Elena Rybakina?
Yeah.
Or was it D, Serena Williams?
Right, at least you can pronounce the last one, but I don't think it was her.
Yeah, she's American, yeah. So that's kind of okay. But I can't pronounce the others. When I was actually writing this quiz down, I was just like, God, how am I going to pronounce those names?
Venus Williams?
We've got some... Bonzo Deathburger says you broke up, say again, but I'm not sure on which one. And he said Hugh Edwards.
Yeah.
And Angela said about the Wimbledon one, don't know and don't care. That's not the spirit of the quiz, Angela, really, is it? Well, we've all got to have a go.
Well, look, I think Angela and Bonzo Deathburger might like round two.
Okay, well, let's do a round two on geography.
Okay, so round two on geography. Are you ready?
About as ready as I ever be.
Yeah, you any good at geography, Leo?
Not especially, no.
Angela would be good at geography. Angela's travelled a lot of places and she knows a lot of places. If it's north of Exeter, I get a nosebleed and I don't know where it is.
What city lies between two continents?
Budapest.
Huh?
Budapest.
What did Andrea say?
Oh, Angela's put Angel of the North.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, but anyway, right.
Let's have a geography quiz. Yeah.
Okay, quick fire. Which country has the longest coastline in the world?
No multiple choice.
Oh, there's no multiple choice on these. Okay. Sorry.
Okay, that's it. Okay, question on two.
Okay, what is the capital of Malta?
Oh, God.
M. Okay. And what do you think, Leo? Yeah. Oh, he's struggling. Okay. And question three.
Okay. Question number three. What is the oldest recorded town in the UK?
Oldest recorded town.
And town, not city. What is the oldest recorded town in the UK?
In the UK, though. Could be older.
Could be. I'm going to say that, though.
Yeah?
Yeah, because it's. I know that's in the Doomsday.
Come on, Walt. Mr. Who drives around the country.
Yeah. Okay. Question four.
Question four. What is the name of the largest river to flow through Paris? That's easy.
That's the same. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay, and the last question.
And the last one. Right. Mount Vesuvius casts a shadow over which modern Italian city?
That's a good question, because it erupted over Pompeii, didn't it? But then it destroyed Pompeii. So what was built on the site of Pompeii? Okay,
really
right, that's fine.
Come on, Neil.
We're going to think on these tracks. I'm going to hang up and call you back after we've had a little bit of rock and roll.
Mm-hmm.
And we'll get the answers.
Could you do me a favour? Could you stop playing this dreadful death metal music? I hate it.
We're going to play a little bit more death metal in a minute. No, we're going to play some rock and roll now. You'll love this.
It's only rock and roll, but you'll like it. Not a lot, but you'll like it.
And we'll call you back in a mo.
Thank you.
Bye. Right, here you go. You'll like this. This is a band This is a band called The Baseballs, and this is their version of Chasing Cars.
Fantastic.
Boy, he's proud he hasn't had this on his
Cover me.
Here we go.
Oh, we're having great fun. Great
That's
fun.
That's good,
with that
though, isn't it?
Isn't it? Yeah.
Andrea doesn't like death metal.
There we go.
So what we're going to do is we're going to phone back. We can't get this phone thing working because it's absolutely awful. There is an option though to put it through to the MacBook.
Yeah, put it through to the MacBook.
So I'm going
to
see if Andrea comes. Oh,
there you go.
Andrea doesn't like death metal. Is that working?
See, we can hear ourselves in the background now.
Yeah. I don't want to do that.
Can you hear us, Andrea?
Hello.
There we go.
Right, we've rerouted the phone now through the MacBook. Because Leo is
Good evening and welcome to the quiz.
Yeah,
there we go.
Now we can hear you straight through.
I've just been looking up some of the answers.
Yeah.
And
a lot of them are wrong.
Oh, hang on, I can't scroll down. Yeah, Bonzo Deathburger, he's put down, you know, the Tamar.
Yeah.
Which was. Oh, Angela got one more one right.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Right, well, let's go.
Nude, and Angela's got another one right.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, interesting.
Okay. Oh, you got
why didn't we just do this in the first place?
I don't know. We realised we can
route
you through the computer, and I don't have to hold the phone up, so I could have written
that. Was the other option I was going to suggest, but I didn't realise that the Mac would automatically do that. But there you go.
There you go. Let's have some answers.
Yeah.
I reckon I've got four.
So we'll go back. Okay. So what are we doing? We're going back to the first round.
Quiz of the week.
Okay, so the NHS celebrated its birthday this week or last week. Can't remember which one. Can you remember how old it is? Was it A, 75, B, 10 years, C, 115 years, or so exhausting, or D, 80 years?
D, 80 years.
I said 75.
Angela said 75.
So did Bonzo Deathburger.
And then Bonzo Deathburger said 75. What is it?
And, yeah, what did you say, Neil?
80, because I thought it was 75 pre-COVID.
The answer is A, 75 years.
Oh, booyah. Well done, Leo.
Nice one.
For me, I need a...
Well done, everyone who got 75 years.
And Bonzo Deathburger.
Question number two. A lion was given VIP health treatment at a London zoo recently. Can you remember what it was for? Was it A, a haircut, B, broken tooth, C, sprained ankle, or D, earache?
Well, I said it was a broken tooth.
Mm-hmm.
Leo said it was a sprained ankle.
Mm-hmm.
And Bonzo Deathburger said it was for a vaginal retread. And Angela said it was for earache.
Well done, Angela. It was earache.
Which was what?
A.
B.
Oh, wait, what? B.
C.
D.
B.
D.
D. D.
D. D. All right, so neither of us got
that.
D for Delta.
So Angela got that. Right, question three.
Okay, question three. As part of the ceremony when King Charles was presented with Scotland's crown jewels, he was also presented with what?
Hugh Edward's crown jewels.
Oh, was he presented with...
Was it A, bagpipes, B, a cape, C, a sword, or D, a sceptre?
Well, me and Angela have both said C, a sword, and Leo said...
D, a sceptre, and Bonzo Deathburger said meat and two veg.
A meat and two veg, says Bonzo Deathburger.
the answer is he was presented with D, a sword.
Oh.
Oh, a sword. D, a sword.
D, a sword. For Delta, a sword.
Yeah.
Yeah, Delta sword.
Okay, so Angela and Leo got it right. Me and De Bonzo Deathburger got it wrong. I'm zero at the moment.
Yeah.
I don't know what Bonzo Deathberg is playing at.
Yeah. I think he must have interference from another quiz.
Yeah.
A rather rude one.
Okay,
next question. Question number four. So this week or last week, we learned that a group of owl chicks were found in a very strange location.
They were.
Mm.
Was it A, Buckingham Palace, B, Glastonbury Festival, or C, Stonehenge, or Angel of the North?
Well, Bonzo Deathburger says you broke up, say again, because I think he missed that one. Angela said Angel of the North. I said Stonehenge, and Leo said B, which was
Glastonbury.
And Angela's now said Glastonbury as well. But Bonzo Deathburger said that a group of
owls. Leo, well done. Hey. It was Glastonbury Festival.
And Bonzo Deathburger said that a group of owls were found on Hugh Edwards. Right. So. Is that it for the first one?
No, we've got one.
I've got one more.
No, I'm at question number five.
Okay.
Slow down, Neil. Slow down. Keep calm. Right, question. The iconic tennis tournament Wimbledon is underway, but can you remember who was the women's singles champion last year?
I think the question would be, can you pronounce who was the women's champion next year?
So, was it A, Coco Gauff or Gaff or Gauff? Emma
Raducanu. Yeah.
Eleanor Rubakic. And D, Serena Williams.
B, Raducanu. And Angela said she went B, Raducanu, and Leo went C.
It was C, Eleanor
Rubakic. Nice. That's a ping for Leo.
Nice. So far,
okay, so there you go. That's that one done. Moving on very quickly to general knowledge.
Yeah.
General knowledge.
Joggers. Sorry.
Geography. Ooh. Right, which country has the longest coastline in the world?
Bonzo Deathburger says the UK. Angela says Peru. I say Norway. Leo says Scotland.
Oh, wow, awesome. Guys. You are so far out. It's Canada.
Ah, okay. Fair enough. Yeah.
Nice. Okay.
Nobody got that one right. Yeah.
Okay. Question number two on geography. What is the capital of Malta?
Angela says, don't know. Bonzo Deathburger says,
Falcon.
Oh, no, that can't be that question.
No, that might be another one.
And I say M. The capital of M? Malta is M. Capital M, A-L-T-A.
Mm.
You're all wrong.
Okay.
The answer is Valletta.
Oh, okay. Valletta.
Yeah. Oh,
or Valletta.
No, don't know that.
Mm. Okay.
You're bloody rubbish, a lot of you.
Aren't we?
Right. What is the oldest recorded town in the UK? And Angela got this right.
Angela says Colchester. Bonzo Deathburger says Bude. I said Liscard because it's in the Doomsday Book. And Leo said
Stoke.
Well. Angela got this right. It is Colchester.
Colchester, yeah, Colchester, no way.
Nice. Yeah, nice.
Yep, and I did say town, not city, so she got it right.
Okay.
Hang on. Well done, Ange.
Mm.
Question number four. What is the name of the largest river to flow through Paris?
I know what you're saying.
Oh, see what you did there,
I'm
Leo.
I'm totally sane. You're insane.
Angela says Seine. Leo says Seine. I say Seine. Bonzo Deathburger says the Tamar.
Nice.
And it is the Seine.
Yeah. Hey, get in.
Nice.
And
okay, your very last question. Right. Mount Vesuvius casts... excuse me, sorry. Mount Vesuvius casts a shadow over which modern Italian city?
Vapanapoli.
And I said Pisa.
Oh, and Angela says, can't think of any Italian cities apart from Rome.
Mm.
It's been a long day. Bonzo Deathburger says, the garden is very obvious behind the green door.
He's talking about Shaking
Stevens. That's to do with Shaking Stevens, not to do with the quiz.
Right. I'm going to play a little bit of Shaking Stevens in a minute.
Yeah, nice.
Okay. Right, do you want the answer then, Neil?
Yeah.
Okay, well, come on, it's really obvious. Naples.
Oh, Naples.
Naples.
Yeah, well. Okay, so let me just tot up the scores here. So I got 1, 2, 3, 4.
Tot up your scores.
I got 5, and Neil got.
I got 1.
I reckon Neil got that.
I got one.
Yeah, which was the same.
I got Leo got 5, and for all the chit chatting, we're going to play a little bit of Shaking Stevens. How many did Angela get? Angela did well in the joggers.
Yeah. I think she must have been about 5 as well.
Thank you for that, darling. Yeah. Can we have an easier quiz next week?
Yeah, and
no.
Oh. What happened
to want an easier quiz, you have to be really nice to me.
What happened to the cat quiz? We were going to have a cat quiz.
Yeah.
I was going to do cats, but
Well, that was to bounce out for dogs, which segues nicely into...
None of us have got cats, so...
Yeah,
that's true.
Yeah, but...
it'd be too hard.
It was because you did the quiz on dogs, wasn't it? Because it segues nicely into what Angela was asking us to do, is re-mention the doggies, as indeed Steve Prout had Angela and Giles on a couple of weeks ago to talk about doggies.
He did.
Yes,
he did, and he put the advert up on his show yesterday.
Yes, indeed. For some reason, it's not actually in our one. Somehow, our folders are different. Yeah. Somehow, I'll get that sorted out for next week. But that research is still on, so people do still check out our Facebook page, check out our website, check out the Prout Show. You get all the details on there in the interim until I pop all up on our Facebook and get it into our advert cycle while we're playing music as well.
Which will we do. Right, Andrea, thank you very much for the quiz. We're going to sign off and play some music. And seeing as everybody's talking about him, we'll catch you later. Have a listen to this. You'll like this one as well. I'll see you later. Boy.
And she's gone already.
Oh, she's gone.
She's gone.
So... he's got a new album out, Shaking Stevens. This isn't off it.
No.
But following on from Chasing Cars, let's have a little bit of As Long As I Have You by Shaking Stevens. And you're right, Bonzo Deathburger. The guy is a legend. And
I used to dance to him when I was a baby. I'd hang on to the... when I was learning to stand, I'd hang on to a table and shake my ass to Shaking Stevens.
Well, I've got an ongoing bet with Andrea because I've WhatsApped and messaged directly Shaking Stevens and asked him to come on the show, and Andrea said he never will. Shaky, if you're listening, why wouldn't he be?
Why wouldn't he be, yeah.
Get your ass on the show. Owen Paul's coming on next
week. Exactly, Owen Paul's in next week. Fingers crossed, so yeah.
So have a listen.
Get on board.
Bit of vintage Stevens.
Yeah.
What a great... tune.
Yeah,
and I just said that classic bit where you get and it goes up an octave, and I can hear just Charlie and Richard going, it's not up an octave, mate, it's up a semitone or whatever it is. It's I know. Again, I hit shit. I don't play things, I just hit things.
Yeah.
What time is it?
It is time for Tipple of the Week.
We've got a stinger for Tipple of the Week.
Yes.
How long have we had that?
Quite a while. I've been putting it in the video edits. It's just I only just... Well, because we've got our new stinger machine, haven't we?
Because the
track link machine is now actually relegated to actually being a CD player, so we can play CDs, one of which you do have for us to play at some point up there, a new one.
I do, yeah. Actually, we should play that next week. We'll play that. They're in the track listing. Yeah. To play, but we'll play their CD.
CDs is a good look. I mean, typically it'll be the one time that it doesn't actually work, but
we've got backup on Spotify.
Yes.
Yeah. So, Tipple of the Week.
Indeed,
Get you laughing here around this little fella. I don't know why I've gone all Cockney, because it's from down in St Agnes. So, our good and lovely friend Johnny.
Wrap the gums round this thee.
Aye.
What was I was watching? I was watching Ladies Who Wear Lavender yesterday.
Were you?
The day before, with a good lady driver and a good nanny driver who's upstairs. Big shout out to Nanny
Teresa.
Quite an
appropriate can then, because it's in lavender.
Yes, exactly. And that was filmed in St Austell, believe it or not, just up the road. And it has Dame Judy Dench, Dame Maggie Smith, rest in peace, and Miriam Margolyes all in it. But the young actor who plays the Polish boy who washes up on the shore... is the Winter Soldier in Captain America now, Bucky Barnes.
Oh, okay.
I couldn't watch it without seeing Bucky Barnes all the way through. It's just like so weird, especially some of the things that happen in him. I'm like, hey, you ain't going to be laughing like that when they've chopped your arm off and stuck cyborg implants into you, buddy.
You do get a few people like that where you see them in one thing and then you can't get them out of context.
Yeah.
And then you become, like Hugh Grant, you become typecast. But I love watching Hugh Grant for Hugh Grant. And if he wasn't Hugh Grant and typecast, it wouldn't be a Hugh Grant.
There were several actors in there as well, or extras. So I'm pretty sure we've seen
talking about
around,
Hugh Grant.
Like, I'm sure
talking about Hugh Edwards. Records.
There's a few locals in there. Like, there's one guy in particular, I'm sure, drinks down the spoons. He always wears a tweed suit. He's got, like, a beard, quite tall guy, nice haircut. Okay. Yeah, yeah. But they're all talking, like, "Ark at thee," and all this. And everyone finishes this when they're referring to someone as "thou." How's Zara doing there?
Yeah.
You know, I'm like, really? Really? Is like everyone in Cornwall spoke like that?
Right, proper corny. So anyway, digress.
Let's get back to it.
Because our good friend Johnny down at Pipeline Brewery, and again, I say this because we've had Pipeline on before, Johnny got into the top 8 independent brewers for the UK.
Yeah.
It's all about the Cornish water, he says, because he doesn't use anything that's necessarily organic or what have you. He uses standard hops, standard brewing processes, but he absolutely nails it. And this is Pipeline Pilsner, vibrant, hoppy, juicy beers crafted on the North Cornwall coast using fresh ingredients and Cornish water. And Johnny says it is all about the Cornish water because it's obviously really soft. It's not hard, scaly lime water. "We create exciting craft beers that showcase the best of New World hops."
The best of New World hops.
And this is 5.5, so it's not mad, it's not mental.
It's not too bad. Yeah.
But honestly, you'll get into this, Leo, and it is an outstanding
dextrin malt
beer.
Maltodextrin.
Yeah.
Nice.
Shall we go? Jewel opening
it's
on the mic.
It's made with Huel and Melon hops. Isn't that interesting? It is made with Huel hops.
Huel hops,
isn't it? Huel hops.
Shall we go
1, 2, 3? Let's kill siege for a moment and see if this is explosive like the BBC's skeleton closet at the moment, or rather quiet and timid like Hugh Edwards on Coronation Day. Let's find out.
1, 2, 3.
Oh,
it's a feisty pull of the ring.
It's a feisty pull of the ring, but somewhat reflective, much like Hugh Edwards sat in his hospital bed this evening.
Other newscasters are available, allegedly.
Yeah.
Right, you're going to love this.
Yeah, let's have a look-see. I'll tell you what, I swear to God, if we're not actually... Are we still broadcasting? Yeah,
no,
are we still
broadcasting out
there, people? Let us know in the chat room. Bonzo Defberger saying, where is he and is he open tomorrow? Oh, Pipeline. Where is Pipeline and is he open tomorrow?
Okay, yeah, he will be open. Yep. He is normally open... all the time, Bonzo Deathburger. He is basically, if you're familiar, depends where you live, he's in St. Agnes on the old station industrial unit. So if you know where Tim Kelly, the MG specialist, is, just literally as you go in towards the new housing estates opposite the turn off to Mount Hawk, you've got a little industrial estate. It's called the old station because there's the old station house. And he's literally the last unit as you drive in, right down the end. If you want to get hold of him, you can go onto his Facebook page. You can go onto his
pipelinebrewery.co.uk.
And you can always give him a buzz. But he is 9 times out of 10 open. And at this time of year, I'm guessing he's relatively busy. Yeah, and you can go in there. He's got a fridge. He's got boxes. He's absolutely. Yeah. And all of his beers... This is my favourite brewery, Pipeline. Yeah, yeah. Every single beer we've had.
Yeah, absolutely brilliant, yeah.
It's top banana. We're going to go down and do a brew day with Johnny at some point and film it all, aren't we? So
Let's have a nose. Sandy saying that was a good quiz, nice mix, and I got 5. Have a little look, see as that. Look at that lovely clarity there, nice amber colour.
Sandy got 5, bloody show off.
Not too prominent ahead, which is a good look. Let's have a nosy on that then.
It's beautiful. It is, honestly. I know I keep saying it, but it's a great beer, this is.
And it definitely saw amber honey aroma.
Have a taste of this.
That is good.
How many of those could you literally just keep drinking at a nice barbecue? Or
that is refreshing. It's crisp.
It is beautiful. It's Pipeline Pilsner as well, Bonzo Deathburger. And if you go down and see Johnny, tell him that Neil and Leo from Fluid Records, you saw it on our Tipple of the Week, because I do say to him, we always put your tipples out, Johnny, and I'm not sure whether he believes us.
Yep, I'm sure if he did mention it, he might well say, you know what, have a little off that. Don't quote us on that, but you can always give it a try.
If you put in code PHLU50, he might just tell you to piss off, but...
Yeah, kind of. scurries across the palate much like a feverish ferret up a drainpipe.
Doesn't it? Yeah. Yeah. It absolutely does. Doesn't linger like Hugh Edwards on a broadcast.
No, it doesn't at all. No. Or yeah.
Whilst we enjoy that, which is literally going to take us about 5 seconds, because it's such a good, easy drink.
Yeah, it's very drinkable. Yeah, could have done with another six of them.
Introduce what you're going to...
Do drink responsibly, people.
Introduce... don't drink responsibly. Drink a lot, because Johnny makes more money.
Drink a lot, but responsibly. Make sure you're at home and within several feet of your bed.
Introduce us to the next video, because I haven't seen this yet, and I'm super excited to see it.
You, Neil, not many. Lightweight, says Claire and Ian.
What? Yeah. I'll have you know that when I went down to the band room, Claire, I had three proper jobs, and that's...
proper job. Good luck. Okay, so...
The last time I went out with Claire and Ian, I went on the train, and I did actually have quite a few to drink, and it was a great night out. But I think they're doing vice versa. They're going to come across and see... they're after seeing the band.
Yes.
They've clearly got nothing better to do.
Yeah. the next video. This is what everyone's been waiting for, I guess, because you may remember last year we had a band in from the Rock Project, Undercover Dungarees, and the Alternative Spoons was the full name, and they did a cover of Learn to Fly by Foo Fighters, recorded right here in the studio in the live room right next door, and we made a video of that.
I think the ultimate accolade to them was you got copyright striked by YouTube, they thought it was Foo Fighters.
They thought it was actually a live version of it. Usually it will just flag it as like a publishing thing, but no, this is a specific live version from, I think, Munich or something.
So that is a good praise indeed for these guys whose average age was 12.
Well, again, similarly with this group, which is Combustion, who you may have seen or heard about the place, especially on Facebook, and also because they were going to be coming down to play the coronation gig that sadly got rained out. We are still looking at doing something local to recompense that with the bands that were going to play, so you get to see them. But in the interim, this was the weekend after Relay for Life. So, it was a pretty chaotic week that week. We had just done like the 24-hour relay two-day festival.
Yeah, that was great fun, though, wasn't it?
Yeah, great fun. Yeah. And then getting back in here and decamping all the equipment again to get them recorded. But they came in the weekend after, and they had literally the night before been at Exeter Phoenix supporting Tipple, hadn't they?
Because I was up there taking their pictures, wasn't I? So we got got some pictures of all sorts, and also of Owen Paul, who we've just said he's coming on to the show.
Who will be on next week?
Next week, so it's all a bit synchronicity, eh?
Yeah, lots of synchronicity. So, they was it?
Oh, look, there's a Morzin poster on the back of the door.
Yeah,
so that, I can't get out of the way.
So yeah, they came in that weekend, and they recorded their own cover of Highway to Hell by AC/DC, which was absolutely fantastic, very professionally done. And without further ado, let's check it out, shall we? Yeah,
let's have a look.
Here's the video for this, so let's check it out.
Living easy, loving free. Season taking a ride.
There you go.
And what's the average age of those guys where you can see?
Well, the youngest was 11, the oldest was 17, I believe.
Crazy.
Yeah, or 12, sorry, 12 and 17.
Under the tutelage, as we always say, of the amazing Cameron Mills, who goes under Thomas Cameron in his alter ego as a singer, entertainer, agent, tutor, runs the Rock Project. Absolutely fantastic. I love those camera angles. And for Angela, if she's still tuning in and she was watching that, yes, that was my drum kit.
Yes, yes, indeed.
Because
yeah.
It records well, doesn't it?
Yeah, it does. It
for some strange reason. Strange reason. It's because I put Evans.
Well, I mean, just proof again, it doesn't necessarily matter about the drummer that's behind the kit in this case. No, that's it. The drummer, as you'll notice in the video as you're watching it, he was super tight. So,
yeah. What are you saying?
Huh?
Saying that I'm not.
No, you're super tight as well. I often relay this, that you're actually a better drummer than you give yourself credit for. But this kid was spot on.
He was really good.
And
absolutely.
Again, not a huge amount to do in the post edit on that one. It was all shot. What you see there is essentially one take. It's one take shot across multiple cameras. So no camera trickery or anything. That was just them rocking in there. We did a 3-hour session and basically had them recorded and done in about two and a half hours. So
yeah,
absolutely fantastic work by them. And obviously that was our first playing of it there, but we will be uploading that to YouTube. You'll be able to find it there and on our website over at vision.fluidrecords.co.uk.
And then we will start the war between them and the undercover dungarees. Claire and Ian are saying shots. And I don't know whether they're talking about your camera shots or basically me and Claire doing shots. Because I refuse to do shots. I never like doing shots. I never know where I am with shots. I know where I am with beer. Mm. You start doing shots and Claire and Ian are living proof of this. You're all over the place.
Mm. And Angela's there saying it doesn't really matter about the drummer indeed. Yeah. Yeah. Because the kit sounds fantastic. Yeah.
Unbelievable. I'm just going to have to resign.
No, I mean, it does matter because if the drummer is well out of whack, then I have to spend another 2 days putting them in time, which is a long, long effort. Pocketing stuff is a pain in the ass.
Bonzo Deathburger coming in with some interesting facts about the, I was going to say the late, great Carol Decker, but of course she's still very much alive.
I
had sex with Carol Decker once. She was
allegedly.
She was a proper prima donna and allegedly kept insisting I had a shower after every orgasm. And suffixes it with struth and 2 exclamation marks. Angela says, I hate to admit Neil never drops a beat. He is definitely better than he thinks he is. I do drop a beat. I just hide it extremely well and point at the bass player and blame him.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's easy. The methodology. That's
absolutely.
Good classic drummer methodology right there.
Right, okay. Whilst we got a few people in the chat room, first person to type in, we'll get the next tune out of our playlist, right? Mm. You can have the new Vengeance single, which is a cover of Glass Animals' Heat Waves. You can have the new Grace Lightman single, which is One Night Stand. Well, it's not new, but it's her newest.
Yep.
Or you can have the new Yonica single, Give Me My Halo.
So 1, 2, or 3 in the chat rooms. First 1 for Vengeance, 2 for Grace and 3 for Yonica.
And we'll go with the first person who comes in.
I'm going to send in it's a difficult choice. It really is. I'm going to kind of edge on the 1 myself because I haven't listened to any Vengeance for a little while.
Sandy's in with Grace.
There you go.
Grace Lightman. So we are going to have Grace Lightman, One Night Stand. Great choice, by the way, as well.
I'm talking about my female friends of mine. They think he's and he's gonna come over in his helmet and leathers. I'll be waiting by my door. Stand. I'm talking about the man I got to know. It's sweet, it's ooh.
Leo's absconded from the studio. That is Grace Lightman, One Night Stand. Say that's not her brand new single. That was out a few months ago, but that's her latest single. I don't know where Leo's disappeared to. He's just left me in the studio on my own. Bonzo Deathburger's come in with Yonica. So what we will do, Bonzo Deathburger, because, yeah, that is one of my most interesting new discoveries, Yonica. About 18 months ago, I saw them live supporting Nothing But Thieves. Actually, incidentally, with our bass player Rich from the Morzin, we went to see Nothing But Thieves at Plymouth Pavilions, and Yonica were the support act, and they were absolutely fantastic. Really kind of interesting mix of rock and harmonies and all sorts going on in there. So we will have their latest single, only just come out, and we'll play out with that one when we finish at 9 o'clock. Just promising Bonzo Deathburger the Yonica tune for a play out.
Oh, okay.
That Grace Lightman tune's great, isn't it?
Yeah, it's
I just said you've absconded and left me all on my own.
Yeah, I don't know what we were.
I've got one in here as well, because Andrea, bless her, because she does the quiz every week and she hates death metal, and we play quite a lot of that. I've actually put Amy Winehouse's Back to Black in this playlist, because Andrea's a big fan of Amy Winehouse, so we might between now and the end sneak a bit of Amy in and then close on Yonica. Claire, so today is the 50th anniversary of Queen,
from
their very
song,
first album. Claire and I had a disagreement earlier, and we promised that we would never ever talk about this again. So in the interests of a non-disclosure order, I'm just going to broadcast it over the radio show and upload it onto YouTube. I don't like, wait for it, Claire's going to know what I'm going to say. I don't like The Who.
Fair enough.
Do you like The Who?
Not the biggest fan.
Claire said we're never to have this conversation again. We're going to have to agree to disagree, and she's going to have to redress our friendship.
Okay.
Oh, and incidentally, I should say, because Angela's in the chat room and Claire is in the chat room, I'm hoping here that Angela's working out that this is Claire who gets us all the gigs down at St. Austell Band Club. Because they might not have realised that, Claire might not know that Angela's the soundie, and Angela might not have realised it's Claire and Ian from Band Club. Yeah. But I was also talking to Claire earlier about Ian, her husband, who is in the Dreckley Boys. Now, don't do don't it, do says it. Claire. No. We're not going to play The Who. This is a Who-free zone.
No, no.
But Claire's husband, Ian, is in the Dreckley Boys. And we had this conversation a little bit earlier because we're trying to get the Dreckley Boys or some of them into the studio to do some live singing. So for those who don't know, the Dreckley Boys are like a
male voice choir.
Male voice choir, exactly what they are. And Ian has recently started working for McSalvers, the crane company. And one of his colleagues the other day, who's got a bit of a heart condition, had on site a heart attack. And it was only due to the fact that they had a defibrillator on site that when this chap had the heart attack, somebody had got the training with the defibrillator, used it. When the paramedics turned up, they said that had basically saved his life.
Yeah.
And two or three of the Dreckley Boys have got heart conditions. And we can sympathise with that because our bass player Richard's been in and had some... he's got some issues at the moment with his heart and, and so on. So they have raised enough money to purchase a defibrillator to put outside of the band club in St. Austell. They are also trying to raise money through their gigs to get a second defibrillator to put outside of the Treganissi Music Club, just outside of St. Austell. And they're raising money to do a third purchase of a defibrillator on another club in St. Austell. So all these live music events will ultimately have, if people back them and support them and donate and go and watch them,
do it
absolutely.
Do it.
So Claire is having lunch with some of the Dreckley Boys on Saturday. She's our go-to PA for St. Austell. If Claire asks you to do something, you don't argue, you just do it and get it done. And as Arnie says in his latest FUBAR series, that's it and that's all. So you just
not screw your freedom.
No, not that one.
Not that one again.
So the Dreckley Boys will be ultimately on this show. We're trying to get them. There's loads of them and they're difficult to get together. But yeah, get behind these guys because that is absolutely doing a fantastic thing.
They do make a huge amount of difference.
Yeah.
It's not the only case. I know of many cases actually over the years of people who have been saved by defibrillators.
Yeah.
Including one that was put in Corn Street outside our old pub, the old John Cabot. Saved someone one night then.
Oh, so, here you go. We've got an online chat going between. What's the difference of, you know, when you get a bromance? So that would that be a cismance?
I guess.
We got a cismance, but that doesn't sound right, does it? But yeah, so the Dreckley Boys watch this space. We It'd desperately want.
It'd be a romance.
Could be.
Romance.
Yeah, it could be. Yeah.
Angela's saying, don't make nauseam sound decrepit. You're all young, fit and sexy. But great news on the D-fibs.
It is great news on the D-fibs, So, yeah. But yeah, there's three of the Directly boys that have realised that they've got some issues with their heart because none of us are getting younger. Mm. And Claire said, you know, do you need to look then for a charity? Surely it's in what you do. And that is fantastic.
Yeah.
So we'll get them on. We'll big them up. We'll share their Facebook page. We'll share their posts. We'll get them on the show. And hopefully they're going to be sort of doing some tours, and then you just go along and chuck some money in the bucket or whatever they're shaking at you.
Yeah.
And believe you me, you need to chuck money in the bucket because Ian is a massive fella and he's one of the smallest. You don't want to mess with these guys. Mm-hmm. It's like going up against the All Blacks.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So if they shake the bucket, you put your money in.
Yeah. But they can sing. Trust.
They can. They can sing so we went to see them, didn't we?
Yeah. Yeah. Absolutely fantastic. It was really, really good.
Yeah.
I'm actually hoping we do get another chance to record them live as well.
Yeah.
So. That'd be great.
Yeah.
It'd be great to get a recording that actually works this time.
Yeah, but there's going to be plenty of opportunity. Bonzo Deathburger. Roger Daltrey is one of the biggest
known
I'm not even going to read that out.
When off camera, Who is quite possibly the most overrated band ever. I know this because I once had sex with Pete Townsend, who's like trying to shag a windmill.
Claire is going to have something to say about that. Just interim for Andrea, just to cleanse her soul of the death metal. Should we play a bit of Amy?
And so interesting, because like, so we've had Amy and Queen mentioned here. So interesting facts about Queen. I went to the same university and college as Freddie Mercury.
I think Bonzo Deathburger shagged Freddie Mercury.
John Deacon was not the first bassist in Queen, despite what the Freddie Mercury biopic, which was complete lies, would tell you. And I met Brian May at a party once, which was great fun. Yeah,
married to Anita Dobson, famously.
Wedding party. Well, actually, I think this was pre-marriage to Anita Dobson. It was a long time ago. It's where I actually, it was with John Rhino Edwards, and it's where I got my first copy of Cubase for PC.
Nice.
John Rhino Edwards.
Amy
Sounds Winehouse, like the second one being there, is the good lady driver and I had our wedding reception in the Master Robert Hotel, which is where Amy Winehouse was proposed to and had her reception. We were the last people in there before it got knocked down as well.
That's impressive.
Yeah, it's now a Hotel Ibis on the Great West Road. So,
let's have a bit of the dulcet tones of Amy Winehouse.
Okay.
So we've played this for Andrea after she's had a thrash metal session. Someone else there, especially for Sandy.
Yeah, yeah.
I tell you what, you don't phone up to most radio stations and just like randomly bung a song in and get it played, do you?
No. Very rarely. Very rarely indeed,
absolutely.
It's usually very heavily vetted.
And we're almost, Leo, at the end of another show. Again, it feels like you've never been away. It's nice to have you back.
Yeah, everything's falling apart again.
Quite literally putting the band back together.
Yeah. No, it's good to be back. And there's still a few little things on its iron out with these new fandangled bits and bobs that we've added.
Well,
at least we've got the phone working.
If we can get our funding, we can get our new unit sorted, can't we?
That'd be nice, wouldn't it?
Yeah. Everybody just donate £1 million.
Yeah. We'll have more on that in the near future, I'm sure. Like, more to talk about with that. What was that? Yeah, Sandy saying, don't play Amy, play someone else. I remember when she died, it was Carole King they phoned or someone. And like, she's like, why are you phoning me? Because like, this woman just ripped off all of my music and like, I haven't seen a penny for it, and Mark Ronson's a charlatan. And I can attest to that because I worked in the studio right below him, and yes, he is a complete charlatan.
Yeah. I'm not a massive fan of Mark Ronson, to be honest. He did. It was the Zootons, I think, who originally wrote that song that he covered with Amy Winehouse. Although the name of the title of the song completely escapes me.
Well, again, it's one of those things of supplanting the originals. You know, it's one of the things that's sort of slightly depressing when you listen to mainstream radio. You know, we've had BBC Cornwall on, and even to a certain degree, Pirate. Where just everything they're playing is just old tunes with someone chatting crap over the top of it. There's not a single original idea out there. Yes, there is. It's just we're the only people playing them.
It wasn't Mark Ronson. It was that other DJ who used to work in a warehouse, and they had his like story of he used to work in a warehouse, and now he's a DJ. As though if you work in a warehouse, you must be stupid, and how could you possibly progress to being a DJ?
Mm.
And he ripped off "How Soon Is Now" by the Smiths.
Okay.
And all also did another Smiths tune for which I've never forgiven him because you can't cover the Smiths. The Smiths.
Wasn't
the Smiths.
We're not talking about Avicii, are we?
Not Avicii. No, the other fella. I mean, he's so up there and in the forefront of my mind that I can't even remember his name.
Yeah.
But you know, you can never forget the Smiths. Angela's not a fan of the Smiths. But
Valerie,
that's the one. Yeah. Now, didn't the Zootons, Bonzo Deathburg? I think the Zootons did the original Valerie. Correct me if I'm wrong.
Yeah.
Why and don't then you Mark come Ronson, over, Valerie. Yep. But the Zootons is a much better version.
And no, actually, saying, the soda drinkers.
Wurzels.
Wurzels, their version's fucking awesome
They're
as well,
brilliant,
man.
Brilliant, the Wurzels. Yeah. Angela saying, lovely to see you, Leo, and still loving the hat.
Thank you very much, thank you. In fact, I do actually have an array of these. I should probably switch up. Like,
but they're all the same, so well, you can't tell which one you're wearing.
They're all the same sort of trilby, but like, I've got different varying colours. Yeah. I even have some to match different outfits. Like my good brother, Mexican Iron Man, Latino Slant Paulie, shout out to you out there. He's got a fine collection of trilbies as well. So, maybe I should take a hint from my Latino brother there and start swapping them out. I can.
Tis being your signature headgear, so it tis being, so it is. We're at the end of the show. I promised Bonzo Deathburger.
Can't cover the Smiths, says Angela. No, you absolutely can't, because much like Bumblebee, I can't stand the Smiths.
We tried.
Morrissey, man. Morrissey's the only guy that can get his
I've just turned Leo's mic off.
He's the only guy that can get his entire tour cancelled by saying, I don't want any meat eaters in the stadium. You're not allowed to serve meat. So Ireland went, okay then, we're not having you. Get out.
It's a good job I can't hear you and I've got my fingers in my ears. Anyway, I was going to say, we promised Bonzo Deathburger we'd end the show with Yonica's new single.
Yeah.
So we're going to do that, Leo. But before, and we haven't had this for 4 weeks.
Yeah. I have to say, Prout's actually done a great job of it. He did a brilliant job last week, and he did it on his show last night as well.
He said last week, though, only because he was reading it off the screen.
Yeah. Well, he's actually got the algorithm up now. So, as we usually like to say, do please not forget to feed the head of algorithm or Ronald Reagan, whichever one you choose to in this particular occasion, which funnily enough, actually, I saw a wicked video the other day, an advert for a real video, Ronald Reagan stand up, an hour of comedic anecdotes from Ronald Reagan's tours across the world at various UN general meetings and stuff.
He famously did say a week is a long time in politics and 3 weeks is twice as long. That's a classic Ronald Reagan quote.
Exactly. Yeah. It's all stuff like that. So, look out for that one if you can find it. But please don't forget to feed the head of algorithm. Like, share, follow, and subscribe wherever you're watching us, wherever you're tuning in, wherever you are following us. We are on Facebook @Fluid Records and Twitch @Fluid Vision, Mixcloud @Fluid FM, Instagram @Fluid Records, YouTube @Fluid Vision, and on Twitter @FM Fluid. And I see Neil just looking over there wondering why it is that thing's going mental, isn't it?
It is going mental. Those are all the people that are around the globe that are listening to us.
That's actually just it. Waiting until it finds that one there. There we go. But please, like, share, follow, subscribe. It does help us out massively. We don't often get up into the algorithm onto the suggested videos and things like that because we're small and growing. But every like, every share, every follow, and every subscription helps us along our way. Do comment as well. Comments really help us as well. Stick it to the algorithm, feed Al Gore there a little bit, give him some of his fishy kibble bits,
absolutely,
and help us out a little bit.
And
of course,
I'm just going to read the last bit of the chat room, Leo. Yep. Is I'll remind you of that next time you mention it. That's Angela saying about our band trying to cover the Smiths. Mm-hmm. Sandy said, nice show, guys, with a kiss. And Bonzo Deathburger says, the president's brain is missing. That, of course, was spitting image, I think.
Yes, indeed.
The president's brain is missing. Yep. And he used to have those two buttons on the side of his bed, Reagan. One was nurse,
the other one was nuclear war. Yeah, it's fantastic. But as you would have just seen there on the screen, if you do want to check out this show or any of the other 136 shows in our video on demand, or the over 270 shows in our radio on demand, then get on over to fm.fluidrecords.co.uk or vision.fluidrecords.co.uk. Okay. Don't forget to check out this week's edition of the Cornish Times, where you'll find our interview with Kitty Crocker, as written by Steve Prout this week.
And of course, the previous Cornish Times, everybody will have their gig guide pinned to their fridge. Lots going on this weekend.
Yeah. Well, we've got scribes down on Newquay for a start.
Very, very quickly going to do this, and then we're going to say goodnight. Mm. We started 5 minutes late, so I don't see why we can't run 5 minutes over. It's not as if we're being regulated by Ofcom.
Nope.
So on Thursday, June the 13th, Luke Deakin is at the Bullers in Loo. Friday the 14th, Ross Kelly is at the Bullers in Loo. Theo Miss and Banda Bar Silo at Gallant. OK Radiohead are at the Ship. Jew Barf are in the Bullers in Loo. Jamming Session are at the Copley Arms in Hessenford. And our good friend Mr. Flex is at JJ's in Liscard. Yeah. On Saturday the 15th, Leo, Walk the Talker in the Bullers. The Bullers have got it all going on.
Yeah.
Mind Your Manners are in the Social Club in Callington. Big hi to Tracy out there. She's lovely. Stargazer are in the Social Club at Treganissey. Yeah. Hi, Heather. The Hepcats, that's Wolfie's band,
yes,
are down at the Copley Arms in Hessenford. Hi, Amanda. The Hell of Us are at the Globe. Hello, Anuska. Mm-hmm. XLR are at the Social Club in Saltash. Hi, Julie. And Joe 90 and the Bucket Hats are at JJ's at Liscard. Hello, mm-hmm. Jamie at JJ's. Mm-hmm. And on Sunday the 16th, Side Effects are at the Bullers. Ross Kelly is at the Copley. The Clatters are at the Globe. And next Wednesday, the Old Time Sailors are at Bar Silo,
yes,
in Gallant.
Sandy,
we are going to play out.
Before you go, Sandy says Bonzo needs to get on your show.
We'll have Bonzo on the show.
There's one other thing that I was supposed to
mention. More than welcome.
No, it's gone.
And we're going to play out for Bonzo. This is Give Me Your Halo by Yonica. Good night all. And thanks
indeed
to everybody for being in the chat room. We'll catch you next week.
Indeed. Enjoy.
Toodle pip.
Bye.